SpaceX is making tremendous progress in preparation for its upcoming major launch, Ship 36, designated Flight 10. At the same time, Blue Origin is facing significant challenges with its New Glenn hardware, while Axiom Space recently announced a major change in its executive leadership, specifically regarding its CEO position. Let's talk more in today's episode of NR Studio. While we may have to wait a few more weeks before we see the launch of Flight 9, that doesn't mean that progress has stalled. Indeed, SpaceX is diligently advancing its preparations for the future. A major advancement is the progress made in the work related to Flight 10, which recently underwent a significant development. This was illustrated by the announcement of the line closure, which indicated the relocation of S-36, the ship designated for Flight 10, from the manufacturing facility to a large test site. On April 26, SpaceX launched Makeup a 2, showcasing S-36 in a prominent position atop its carrier bay. By late morning, S-36 had officially been removed from the bay. Remarkably, at this point, S-36 had not yet installed its stern cover. This suggests that, like Ship 35, the stern cover will be installed at a later stage. Additionally, the heat shield appeared to be incomplete, revealing several unusual areas that suggested ongoing development or pending final refinement. Later that day, S-36 was quickly moved to the Massy test facility, after which SpaceX began its testing campaign with great speed the following morning, on the 27th. The team began with an effective venting procedure, then performed a vigorous fuel loading of both S-36 tanks. Frost observations indicated that both tanks were fully saturated, pushing the fuel tanks to their maximum capacity. Following the fueling, subsequent tank releases demonstrated a smooth test execution, indicating its success. Given that S-36's flight schedule is not subject to stringent constraints, SpaceX is expected to conduct several additional rounds of testing. They will likely engage in experiments with varying fuel levels to comprehensively identify and resolve potential issues, while also gaining deeper insight into the limitations of the tank's capacity. These assessments will facilitate verification of the ship's reliability and operational readiness for flight. Following the completion of the Massy testing phase, S-36 will be reintegrated into the production facility to begin the next major milestone, engine installation. This consistent progress underscores the significant momentum SpaceX has achieved in preparation for Flight 10. In March, they successfully conducted cryogenic testing on B-16, the super heavy booster intended for Flight 10. B-16 is currently in Mega Bay 1, where its engines are installed. Once the engines are installed on the ship in rocket boosters, they will undergo a static fire test and a thorough final inspection, facilitating preparations for the next stacking and launch. Furthermore, the proactive steps taken for Flight 10 underscore the company's confidence in the completion of Flight 9. SpaceX is fully committed to maintaining a strong launch cadence, and the readiness of Flight 10's hardware for post-Flight 9 deployment ensures a smooth continuation of momentum. Furthermore, the operation does not end there. B-15, designated for Flight 11, is currently undergoing inspections in Mega Bay 1-1, while B-17 has successfully completed its cryogenic testing. On the maritime side, S-37 has completed its stacking operations, while the initial segment of S-38 was observed coinciding with the departure of S-36 from Mega Bay 2. It is clear that we are approaching a very dynamic and exciting phase for Starship operations. However, the critical factor in accessing this future lies in the success of Flight 9. Preparations for this important mission are proceeding with great precision and precision. S-35's arrival at Massy for static fire testing is imminent. Next, both S-35 and B-1 will undergo thorough inspection, installation, and preparation ahead of their launch. If you're excited about SpaceX's unwavering progress and upcoming endeavors, express support by commenting, "Keep up the good work." Let's give a round of applause to the incredible teams making history with their daily efforts. Don't forget to like the video and subscribe to our channel to stay updated on SpaceX's incredible progress. Your support is critical as we work toward the milestone of 10,000 subscribers. I greatly appreciate your participation in this exciting endeavor. Now let's turn our attention to Blue Origin. The launch of the New Glenn rocket earlier this year signaled a clear intent to engage in a fierce competition with SpaceX. However, they've suddenly run into a major obstacle. Recently, photos emerged of the inside of Blue Origin's factory, with its doors slightly ajar, and the visuals have raised significant concerns. The fuel tanks inside the facility show significant distortion. Such deformation typically results from either significant external forces or from pressure testing, where internal pressures exceed the structural limitations of the tank. Given the nature of the damage observed, it is highly likely that it was caused by a pressure test where the forces applied significantly exceeded the capacity of the material and designed to withstand. At this time, neither Blue Origin, Jeff Bezos, nor CEO Dave Lim have officially commented on the situation. This leaves many questions unresolved. The images do not conclusively indicate whether the damaged tank is a flight tank intended for operational missions, a simulation tank used for testing purposes, or as a prototype for alternative designs. Given its dimensions and placement, I suspect that this tank is serving as a flight-capable tank, perhaps intended for a new booster stage due to its considerable length. An additional critical question concerns the specific mission this tank is designed for. Of course, there is speculation that this tank could be related to the new Glenn 2 booster, especially given that this particular booster has not been publicly disclosed. However, that seems somewhat unlikely. Given Blue Origin's goal of beginning launches as early as June, it is expected that the Glenn 2 booster is already completed or nearly completed. As such, it is more likely that this compromised tank is intended for future operations. Regardless of the specific mission the tank is intended for, this incident undoubtedly underscores the deep concerns regarding the reliability and quality control of the new Glenn hardware. The primary concern lies in determining whether this failure represents an isolated incident or reflects a broader flaw in mass production. If the latter is the case, the consequences could be significant, impacting not only this tank, but potentially the many flight-ready tanks that have already been produced, including those critical for future launches. These circumstances underscore the challenging path that lies ahead for Blue Origin. The company has earned a reputation for its sluggish pace of progress over the years. Despite its vast resources, Blue Origin only launched its first orbital mission earlier this year. They have high aspirations for rapid expansion. However, the current fuel tank woes could lead to significant delays or even outright cancellations of certain anticipated launches. This is not the first instance of hardware issues that have cropped up at Blue Origin. Reports last year indicated that the second stage of its new Glenn rocket experienced apparent technical difficulties during testing for its second and subsequent third flights. While the recent successful hot fire testing of the second stage has eased some concerns, the historical challenges faced reveal a recurring pattern of difficulties that need to be resolved. These potential issues may continue to haunt their initiative. Currently, Blue Origin is poised to begin integration testing for its new Glenn boosters, while simultaneously working to obtain the necessary launch licenses. While the goal of unveiling New Glenn 2 in June is theoretically achievable, the actual situation is far less predictable, especially given concerns over the integrity of their fuel tanks. A comprehensive reevaluation and additional testing could be essential, putting additional pressure on their already tight schedule. In the broader context of the space race, this setback puts Blue Origin at a distinct disadvantage. It originally aimed to compete head-to-head with SpaceX. The disparity between the two companies has only escalated. SpaceX has solidified its preeminent status within the launch sector. Amidst Blue Origin's ongoing challenges, the company finds itself grappling with the completion of even a limited number of missions. Indeed, when evaluating operational success, Blue Origin finds itself trailing not only SpaceX, but also Rocket Lab, which has consistently enhanced its capabilities and garnered an esteemed reputation. That perspective encompasses considerations for the future. At this juncture, it is imperative that we closely observe Blue Origin's forthcoming response. Will they successfully resolve the fuel tank issue, remain on schedule, and achieve the launch of New Glenn 2? Or will this setback lead to further delays? Regardless, the upcoming months will be pivotal in determining the trajectory of Blue Origin and the New Glenn program. Let us now transition to a significant update concerning the alteration in Axiom Space's leadership. On the 25th, Axiom Space formally declared the promotion of Tejpal Bhatia, who has served as the company's chief revenue officer since 2021, to the position of chief executive officer. Bhatia is set to succeed Cam Kafarian, the co-founder of the company who has been serving as interim CEO. To provide context, Kafarian assumed the role of interim CEO in August of the previous year, succeeding Michael Suffredini, who resigned for personal reasons after an 8-year tenure in leadership. Despite Kafarian's resignation from the CEO position, he will persist in his contributions to the company as executive chairman, thereby guaranteeing that his expertise and vision continue to shape Axiom's leadership framework. In their formal communique, Axiom Space lauded Batya's significant contributions over recent years. In her capacity as chief revenue officer, Batya was instrumental in securing contracts exceeding $1 billion and spearheading significant milestones, including the orchestration of the inaugural government procurements of private astronaut missions to the International Space Station. The company remarked, "Tej has served as a pivotal architect of our revenue strategy for the past 4 years, achieving milestones such as securing contracts exceeding $1 billion and enabling the inaugural government acquisitions of private astronaut missions to the International Space Station." Cam Kafarian further articulated robust confidence in Batya's leadership, stating, "Axiom Space was established to push the limits of possibilities in space exploration, and Tej has played a pivotal role in transforming that vision into a tangible reality. His combination of entrepreneurial zeal, international outlook, and steadfast dedication to our mission will undoubtedly position Axiom Space at the pinnacle of the swiftly expanding commercial space sector." Tashbal Bhatia expressed his enthusiasm for the new position in a post on X, stating, "It is an honor to assume the role of CEO of Axiom Space. Since I was young, I have been deeply inspired by the wonder of space exploration, and now guiding Axiom Space at this pivotal juncture is the culmination of my experiences and aspirations. We are increasing our investment in cutting-edge stations, advanced spacesuits, pioneering missions, and innovative space platforms. We are looking for enthusiastic, forward-thinking engineers, technologists, and entrepreneurs who aspire to contribute to the construction of humanity's future home in space. I am very proud to be spearheading Team Axiom." He further expressed his enthusiasm in the company's official statement, stating, "My passion for space exploration has been burning since my early years, and leading Axiom Space during this pivotal juncture in human spaceflight is the fulfillment of a lifelong dream. The appointment of a permanent CEO will significantly strengthen Axiom Space's strategic position. It provides the stability needed as the company expands into key sectors of the space industry. Axiom Space serves as a critical contractor for NASA, spearheading the development of next-generation spacesuits for the Artemis Moon program, which has shown significant progress. Furthermore, Axiom holds a key position in NASA Commercial Space Station Initiative. In anticipation of building their own orbital station, Axiom is actively involved in private missions to the International Space Station, utilizing SpaceX's Dragon spacecraft. Their fourth mission is scheduled to launch in May. Additionally, the company recently revealed its intention to establish an orbital data center, a venture that will ultimately facilitate the functioning of their upcoming space station. However, Batya's challenges extend beyond simply expanding the company operations. They will also require addressing internal challenges. Axiom is currently facing financial pressures due to the large operating expenses associated with managing multiple projects simultaneously. Furthermore, the organization has previously undertaken significant hiring initiatives, and the subsequent increased payroll expenses are now putting significant strain on its financial resources. Compounding the problem, Axiom has recently experienced an exodus of several experienced employees, resulting in critical vacancies that require immediate attention to maintain momentum. It will be interesting to see how Tashbal Bhatia deftly navigates these challenges and steers the Axiom venture into the next chapter. That's it for today's episode. See you in the next episode, and thanks for your support.